Welcome to a video on multiplying polynomials. Let's go ahead and get started. We'll start off by talking about monomials. To multiply monomials, we need to multiply the coefficients and then multiply the variables using the product rule for exponents, which I've stated here. So if we want to multiply 5x squared times negative 3x to the fourth, all of this is attached by multiplication, including 5x squared, which means 5 times x squared. So if we wanted to, we could rearrange the multiplication so that the coefficients were next to each other and the variables were next to each other. Remember, we're allowed to change the order of multiplication due to the commutative property of multiplication. Once it's arranged in this order, it's a little bit easier to first multiply the coefficient together. 5 times negative 3 equals negative 15, and x to the second times x to the fourth, using our product rule, equals x to the sixth. Moving on to number 2, it may be helpful to think of a negative 1 as the coefficient to this first monomial. So again, if we rearrange the order by putting the coefficients next to each other, negative 1 times negative 7 times, now we'll address the x's. We have x, or x to the first, times x to the second, times y to the second, times y to the third. Now when we multiply the coefficients, we'll have a positive 7, x to the third, y to the fifth. Nothing changes when we have three monomials multiplied together. And now if you do this a while, you'll probably skip this intermediate step and first multiply the coefficients together. 4 times negative 2 would be negative 8, times 9 equals negative 72, a to the third times a to the first times a to the second equals a to the sixth. Okay, let's move along to polynomials. To multiply two polynomials, we multiply each term in one polynomial by each term in the other polynomial, and then simplify by combining like terms and write in descending order. So if we have a monomial times a binomial, we have to multiply this 3x times the 2x and also times the negative 5. Now I say negative 5 because I know I can rewrite this if I wanted to as plus negative 5 instead of minus 5. So 3x times 2x, well 3 times 2 equals 6, x to the first times x to the first would be x to the second.
And 3x times negative 5 would be negative 15x, but instead of writing plus negative 15x, we'll write minus 15x.
Number 2, we need to multiply negative 4x squared times all 3 of the terms in the trinomial. So the first product would be negative 12x to the fourth, negative 4x squared times negative 5x to the first would be a 20x to the third, so plus 20x to the third. And lastly, negative 4x squared times a positive 9 equals negative 36x squared. Now let's take a look at a binomial times a binomial. Again, the rule states we have to multiply each term in the first times each term in the second. So you could think of this as first we have to distribute this x into the second binomial, and then we have to distribute the 3 into the second binomial. So you can see we're finding the product of each term in the first times each term in the second. Let's go ahead and try it. X times x equals x squared. I'll mark that off. X times 4 equals 4x, 3 times x equals 3x, and 3 times 4 would be 12. Now you can see here we do have two like terms in the middle, so our final simplified product would be x squared plus 7x plus 12. Now there is a geometric way to represent this product. For example, if we call the length of this side x plus 3, we could call this yellow length x and this blue length 3. And if this side had length x plus 4, we could label this length x and this length 4. And of course, the area of this rectangle would be length times width. So if we take a look at this, the area of the yellow region would be x times x, or x squared. The area of this blue region here would be 3 times this length, which is x, so this would be 3x. The other blue region would be 4 times x, or 4x. And this last region here would be 3 times 4, which is equal to 12. So again, to find this total area by finding this product would result in the same product we found here on the left. Another way to think of it to make sure this is logical is let's assume that x is equal to 4. Well, if x is equal to 4, we'd have 4 plus 4 or 8. And over here we have 4 plus 3 or 7. We know the area of a rectangle that's 7 by 8 would be equal to 56. Let's just verify that this product is also equal to 56 by subbing 4 in for x. So we'd have 4 squared plus 7 times 4 is 12. 16 plus 28 plus 12, which does equal 56. Let's go ahead and take a look at a couple more examples. Here we have another binomial times a binomial. So we'll start with this x and multiply it by both terms in the other binomial. So we'll have x times x, x times negative 2. And we'll multiply the 5 times both terms in the second binomial. Again, you can see we have four products. First product, x times x equals x squared. X times a negative 2, negative 2x or minus 2x. 5 times x equals 5x. And positive 5 times negative 2 equals negative 10. Again, instead of writing plus a negative 10, I'll write minus 10, which means the same thing. Now we combine our like terms. So our final product, x squared plus 3x minus 10. Our number 2, it's the same procedure. We multiply this 4x squared times both terms in the second, and then multiply negative 1 times both terms in the second. So let's take it one step at a time. We may want to write this as 2x to the first to help us. 4x squared times 2x would be 8x cubed. 4x squared times negative 3 minus 12x squared. Negative 1 times 2x minus 2x. And negative 1 times a negative 3 would equal a positive 3. We can see we do not have any like terms, and it's already in descending order, so we're finished here. In the last example, we have a binomial times a trinomial. But again, the process stays the same. We multiply this x times each of these terms in the second. Again, you can think of distributing the x into the second trinomial. Then we have to multiply this negative 4 times the 3 terms in the second. So it's almost like a double distribution. And you can see we'll have 6 products. So the first product, x to the first times x to the second, x to the third, x times 5x plus 5x squared, x times the negative 7. Now when I write the next 3 products, I'm going to write them in vertical form. What I mean by that is here I have negative 4 times x squared, that's negative 4x squared. I'll put that underneath the x squared term. This will facilitate combining like terms. Next, we have negative 4 times 5x, so negative 20x, or minus 20x. And negative 4 times a negative 7 would be a positive 28. Last step to combine our like terms, we would have x cubed plus 1x squared, or x squared, minus 27x and plus 28. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching and have a good day.